Two. Welcome to set number two, ladies and gentlemen, which is the one we've been waiting for this evening. So if everyone can find their seats. I'm very pleased to announce Mr. Corey Harris. As you all know, Corey is a revered blues musician who's traveled the world playing blues and now quite a bit of reggae, too. So thanks very much for coming out again. Corey, thanks for being here.
Thank you, Paul. How's everybody this evening? How about that for that? Yes. You know the warm up we can get. Well, I want to start out by playing some songs that I started out playing when I was maybe 20 years younger, when I was living in New Orleans, Louisiana, playing on the street. It's really where I started my career, and then I would drive to places in Mississippi and Texas and eventually started touring the world. So I'm just going to play some songs that I started out with. This tune is a tune I wrote years ago. It's called High Fever Blues. Blues Come to Texas, which I like to play for my mother. She's a Texan. Mm-hmm. Well, the blue kitty tell me, love and I'm a blue. Well, the blue kitty tell me, love and I'm a blue. Blue kitty tell me, love and I'm a blue. Well, a high-brown woman, man, she's hard to fool. When I walk from Dallas, walk to Wichita Falls. Walk from Dallas, walk to Wichita Falls. When I lost my baby, what's the walking on? Never walk far. See me coming, turn your lamp down low. See me coming, turn your lamp down low. Turn your lamp down low. Well, I ain't no stranger, done been here before. Yeah, done been here before. Going to Dallas, see my pony run. Ain't the best in the world to run this son of a gun. Fulton, which is in the east side of town. Fulton is originally where the city of Richmond began. In fact, Fulton used to be called Rockets Landing, and that was the first port where they unloaded the enslaved Africans and marched them to Shaco Bottom for sale. So Richmond has a very long history in Fulton. That's the first area of settlement. And so thinking about the history and knowing a lot of people who come from Fulton, I decided to write a tune called Fulton Blues, which basically chronicles the progress of the community that became Fulton from way back 200 years ago up until the present time. And it actually got a proclamation from the city of Richmond, this song. And the record of the same name, thank you, record of the same name is called Fulton Blues, and I have that available this evening. So it's just a meditation on the history of Fulton. Well, Fulton, Fulton, what done happened to you?
Well, I've been to the bottom and the top of the hill. Well, I've been to the bottom and the top of the hill. Some people always hungry when some can't get their fill. What a rich man. I go to Mama Avenue down in Richmond Town. Oh, in Mama Avenue down in Richmond Town. Them devils look like devils. I guess I'm Fulton Brown.
Another song I'm gonna play for you off the Fourth of Blues record is called Black Woman Gates. Any Sleepy John Estes fans in the house? Yes, there's one and two, there's four. Okay, you'll win the prize. The rest of you go home and study. But this was a man coming out of Brownsville, Tennessee, one of the great, great songwriters of the blues, very prolific, very long career. Most of his career was spent sharecropping, but he did play the whole time. He wrote a song called Everyone Has to Change Sometime. Brother, I'd be the devil to be that woman, man. Well, I'd rather be the devil to be that woman, man. Well, I lay down last night, I lay down last night, I lay. Well, I tried to take my rest. But my mind got to rambling like the wild geese from the west.
My woman don't drink no whiskey, she don't drink, and girl ain't crazy about wine, crazy about wine. There was nothing but the devil. Cut your kindling, I would cut your kindling, I would cut. Then I made you some fire. When I was told all your water way down from the Bobby Drive, from the Bobby Drive, baby. Actually the oldest song known to man, this song I'm playing now. It's called Tuning. Later it was shortened to be Tuning. But originally it was called Tuning. Very old song. Some of you musicians know what I'm talking about. I should also tell you I have a book. I wrote a book last year about my time with the great Ali Farka Touré. I spent some time with him. We did a documentary film in early 2000. And we also did a record called Mississippi Tamale. And I have a book that I wrote. It's called Jatigi, The Life and Music of Ali Farka Touré. And if you're interested in Malian music, Northern Mali, if you're interested in the war that happened in Mali a couple years ago, you can find all that information inside the book. And of course, I brought my Sharpie too. You know what that means, right? Yes. Need I say more? Well, this next tune I wrote, as is often the case when you're a songwriter, you check the comments to see what's going on, you know. And a particular case that caught my attention was this man, a young man, had a job with the U.S. government. He was working in Hawaii. He had a crisis of conscience, so he got on a plane with a lot of sensitive government documents, and he went to China, and China said, you have to leave here, you're going to start international incidents. So he left China. He went to Russia, and he lived in a transit lounge in the Moscow airport for some time. You remember that man, right? Yes, well, this song was inspired by some of the revelations. It's called Watching You. Watch.
watching you, said they're watching you, and they're watching you. Who you talking to, and they're watching you, they're even listening to, and they're watching you, watching you.
My eyes on you, while you watching what I do. Everywhere I go, who I be talking to? Well, that's every day. Who do remember when them chains and shackles? Remember when the time come again? Well, they're watching you, and they're watching you, and they're watching you. Who you talking to? And they're watching you. They're even listening to, and they're watching, watching you. I can congregate. Don't want I and I to meditate. They say that Bobo shanty violate. It is I and I they designate.
For what? Investigation and prosecution. So much separation in every nation where we're watching you and they're watching you and they're watching you. Who you talking to and they're watching you. They're even listening to and they're watching. Yes, they're watching you. Say. Watching you.
So much for paying attention. Charlie Patton before. Yes. The birth of the funk. Going way back. There's a tune called Pony Blue.
Pony Blue. Don't get worried, brother, don't. We'll see.
Of a country town elementary school, and he was also a reporter for a newspaper way back in the 1920s and 30s called the Chicago Defender. Anyone ever heard of the Chicago Defender? Yes! And he was a newspaper reporter for the Chicago Defender at a time when you could be killed for having a copy of the Chicago Defender in the South. So he was a real hero of mine. His name was Isaac Owens. This is a tune I wrote because he was such a jack of all trades. He was also the chief cotton tester at the cotton gin in Greenville, Texas, which was the largest cotton gin in the nation, in the world at one time. A tune I wrote for him called King Cotton.
Thank you.
York City, way on down to Mexico.
Is that all right? To Mali, if you go to Guinea, you're among the people who speak Mande, Malinke, Jaranke, Susu, Bamana, Bambara, Jula, any of the languages they're going to call Africa Farafina. Farafina. So this is a tune called Farafina.
When you cannot stay, when you got to go,
run and hide? Will you stand and fight for what is right? On that day, never run away. Where you gonna go? What you gonna say? What you gonna do? Oh, mama, 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 Africa, never run away. Church and many other churches in the South, you couldn't play the guitar because the guitar was the devil's instrument. You could only play the tambourine or the piano. Yes. So that's a whole other discussion about why that is so. But suffice it to say that Son House, he had to sit on the fence and live in both worlds because he was a preacher, but he was also an excellent blues singer. And so, of course, he would do the blues thing on Fridays and Saturdays all night. And he would get up in time on Sunday. I don't even know if he went to bed Saturday night. He would get up Sunday morning and preach. And he wasn't the only one. A lot of people did this, but somehow his congregation found out that he played guitar, and so he had to keep getting new congregations. So he wrote a tune called Preaching Blues. It says, I'm going to give you religion. I'm going to join the Baptist church. I'm going to be a Baptist preacher so I sure don't have to work. Yes.
Come on.
talking like a man. Well, I met the blues one morning.
Before, but I'm gonna have to say it again tonight. That was the best performance ever in a Saturday Night Live. Who's with me? Thank you so much, Corey. It was a blessing and an honor to have you here tonight. Folks, on your way, I want to make you aware of a couple things. Be sure to check out the artists on the way out. Once again, Mr. David Gwynn and Mr. Joseph Iacona came for us live tonight. Also, Corey has let me know he's going to stick around for a couple minutes and he'll be signing CDs and books which are available. If you want to stick around and pick something up, you can meet him out here in a few moments. Is it possible, Corey? All right, one more tune.
I heard y'all were wild over here.
I heard about y'all.
Blues nerds in the house tonight, y'all. Yeah, Blind Blake, he came out of Charleston, South Carolina, not West Virginia. He wrote a tune called Too Tight, I Want to Play It For You.
Grab your gown. While I play this rag of mine too tight, this rag of mine too tight won't behave, too tight make you rave, too tight this rag of mine, too tight sick in bed, too tight to my my head too tight. This rag of mine. Too tired, I must confess. Too tired, it's a mess. Too tight, this rag of mine. Well, too tight, hear me sing, baby. Too tight, shake that thing. Too tight, this rag of mine. We're too tight. This rag of mine. Yes, sure enough, y'all are too tight.
Thank you. I got one more tune for you in the song now with the love tune. Ocean breeze, you and me, sweet felicity, baby, you know I love you. How can I be blue with you? Oh, the blue happiness is the best, and I confess that I'm blessed since I met you.
Drive safe and come on back again. We'll be back here next month, March 27th, with John Venora and Abstract Heath.